Okay, so let's hop on over to our Dynamics 365 environment now, and we'll give a little demonstration of the sales literature features. Okay, here I have Dynamics 365. I've got the web interface here loaded in the Chrome browser. As you can see, it's taken me just to my sales dashboard after I've logged in. Now, sales literature is further down here on the left side menu. It's under the collateral heading, and it's the last entry here labeled as sales literature. And you can see by default the view that is programmed is all sales literature, and that happens to be the only out-of-the-box view. Again, if you want to customize maybe by subject or by type, you can go ahead and make a personal view, or you can get your CRM admin to make a system-wide view as well. So let's take a look at an existing record here. For example, we have in my sample data a 3D printer sales literature. We've got an audio product line that may have some literature attached to it. And you can see that there are subjects as far as products, information. Again, these are custom and you can set them to whatever you want to be. And then we do have a type that you can filter against as well. So maybe this is something, policies and procedures, maybe for shipping or returns, something that you may send to clients often. Product sheet, sales literature, we have marketing collateral, company background. All of these are important categories for some of the marketing generated documents that you may have within your organization. So let's go ahead now and make a new entry here, a new sales literature record. We'll just click on the new button at the top of the ribbon here, and we're presented with a pretty straightforward screen as far as what we need to input. Now here we have a title, we have a subject, and we're able to select our type and description. Here we can pick our subject from the default, from the drop down here we have default. We have different queries, they may be information or product questions, we may be service related. Again, this is just the system default here, but we can pick any of these. Let's just pick information for the sake of our company history example. We'll change the type here to company background. And we can give it some background here. We'll just click the save button on the record. Now, after we save, we do have the ability to add sales attachments. Now, this is the important part. The first step is creating the record, giving a title, subject, and the type and description. The really important second step would be to add the sales attachment. So we do that by clicking the three dots here, the more commands button in the sales attachment section. And we can go ahead and add a file from our PC or from our Office 365 storage. So we'll pick the add new sales attachment command here from our more actions menu. And again, we have the time here to add a title, author, keywords if we want to, an abstract of the file if you want to give a more description of the document in plain English. The only mandatory field here is the title, so we'll go ahead and input that in. And we can put as much or as little information into that field as we want. Then we do want to go ahead and choose the file from our computer, so we'll just click the Choose File button, and we're going to get a File Explorer dialog here. We'll just jump over to the desktop, and we will pick this company history PDF. And if we go ahead and save, that's going in the background, going to upload that file and attach it to this company history record that we just created. So now that we've got this sales literature in the system, we have a sales literature record, and now we've attached the file to it. We can actually just hit the back button here and go back to the literature record. And this is one of the first places that we can send this out of the CRM system. So there is a command button here in the ribbon to send us an email, and you can just go ahead and click that. And you can put the from if you are sending email on behalf of other users in CRM. If not, that would be yourself. The to can be any of your contacts, accounts, opportunities, etc. There's also CC and BCC fields that you would expect to have in an email editor. The subject has gone ahead and defaulted to company history since that is our sales literature record name. And we have a little bit of a rich text email editor here. If you want to even go as far as using a template, you can. But you may just want to type an email to your customer and say, hey, we just published our new company history document. Take a look at the attachment. And you can see that Dynamics 365 has already gone and attached the company history PDF that we just uploaded to this email. And then just by clicking send, if your Office 365 account is connected to your D365 account using Exchange Online, your email will send from there. Or if you're using server-side sync, that will send through your Exchange server on-premise as well. So many customers also use Outlook for sending email, and that can be the Outlook application on your desktop, or you may use the Outlook web app as part of your Office 365 subscription. So just switching over to Outlook here on the web really quick to demonstrate how we can send D365 sales literature. We'll just go ahead and make a new message here in our Outlook web app. We'll click the More Commands button down here near the bottom of the Email Compose window. And of course, we'll pull up our D365 add-in app here for Outlook. And then you see this little document here with a dashed outline. We'll go ahead and click that. We can add a template, which we're going to cover in future webinars, or we can go ahead and add sales literature. We'll have to pick our subject here, and we did place that company history PDF under query under information. And we can go ahead and grab company history. And by clicking insert, you can see behind the scenes here that Outlook and Dynamics 365 are talking to one another, and we have that PDF now attached. We can go ahead and compose and send our email. Now this does also work if you're using the big, I call it the grown-up Outlook application, so Outlook 2019, 2016, 2013 on your desktop, on your Windows PC, etc. And the add-in does behave exactly. Just again, look for this icon when you're composing a new message, that little document with the dashed border outline. So that's everything I had prepared for today's webinar. Very short and sweet subject, that is sales literature. Just a quick recap, it is easy to set up sales literature. Again, the key parts are creating the record and then adding the attachment to the sales literature record. It's perfect for controlling what documents are being sent related to sales tasks if you want to keep your sales team all on the same page, all using the most current versions of documents. You can email from the Dynamics 365 interface, or if you prefer Outlook, you can use your Outlook app on your desktop, or you can use the Outlook web app as well. And you can tie sales literature records to competitors or product records. So if you want to have sort of some relationships between products, you can attach their information sheets or perhaps items like instruction manuals to product records in D365.